Hello, class 12th IC students. I wish that you stay safe from this ominous pandemic and have a peaceful mind. Dear students, in English literature, we will go ahead with our Echoes, a collection of short stories. With this story, the story of an hour. Before we start, let us be introduced with the author, Kate Chopin, given in your textbook. Kate Chopin, born Catherine O'Flaherty in St. Louis, Missouri on February 8, 1850 and died on August 22, 1904 in St. Louis, is considered one of the first feminist authors of the 20th century. Born to a prominent St. Louis family, Catherine O'Flaherty read widely as a girl. Married in 1870, Catherine followed the conventional path of a housewife until the untimely death of her husband altered the course of her life. She began to write about the Creole and Cajun people. Actually, these people are the mixed colonial French, African American and Native American ancestors. She had observed in the South about these people. Her early novel At Fault, 1890, was not much noticed by the public, but The Awakening was widely condemned. However, by the 1950s, scholars and others recognized that the novel is an insightful and moving work of fiction. Fiction and the name of novel. Chopin was later also acclaimed for her finely crafted short stories, of which she wrote more than 100. Talented and prolific means in large number, she was influenced by the French short story writer Guy de Maupassant. Chopin placed most of her stories in North Central Louisiana, many in Natchitoches, and she published two significant short stories collections, Bayou Fork in 1894 and then A Night in Acadia in 1897. Some argue that modern feminism was born on her pages. And one needs to look no further than her 1894 short story, The Story of an Hour, to support the claim. This story was first published in 1894 as The Dream of an Hour. The reader, before being republished under the current title in 1895. The reader should note the relationship of the leading figure in that story to the circumstances of Kate Chopin's own life. This story, The Story of an Hour by Kate Chopin, is a protest against patriarchal society. That we should not impose our will upon others. Through this story, Chopin seems to be making a comment on 19th century marriages, which granted the man the right to own and dominate another, means the woman. Now, let us go with the gist of the story. Let us go. The Story of an Hour by Kate Chopin. The gist of the story. The Story of an Hour focuses on the idea that a person may experience drastic changes in a short span of time. Mrs. Millard, the protagonist of this story, is a heart patient. Everyone treats her carefully. When her husband's friend Richards discovers that her husband, Mr. Millard, got killed in an accident, he shares the news with her sister Josephine very gently. Mrs. Millard weeps bitterly with wild abandonment in Josephine's arms, and then she goes to her room to be by herself and locks the room. Inside the room, after a while, she realizes that it is her feeling of freedom. She looks forward to the days ahead instead of dreading them. Outside the locked door of Mrs. Millard, Josephine kneels with her lips to the keyhole and implores to open the door. Mrs. Millard comes out of her room, newly resolved, but meets with a strange surprise. Dear children, today let us keep this suspense as it will spoil the mystery of this story. If you enjoy this story, if you want to enjoy the story, so let us go with the story in detail. So in the next meeting, we will go with this story. Till then, thank you, children.